Talking about the millennial actors, and let's talk about Danielle Padilla, Enrique Gil, James Reid.
Tell
me, my question is, would you do a love story with them?
Yeah, give me a good story. Yeah.
Wow, I mean, that's something.
You know what? Because
I don't want you to play mother or whatever.
No, I want a
love story.
Okay, I was just going through YouTube, and then I saw Kate Beckinsale is dating. I'm so sorry, I can't remember. I'm bad at, you know, names. She's involved with a guy who's from Saturday Night Live, and they're happy together. Mm-hmm. And then they came up with this list of like J-Lo marrying someone younger, always someone younger, like Casper was younger, and now A-Rod is younger. And how come it doesn't seem to matter when it's a much older man and it's a younger woman? Mm-hmm. Like a trophy girlfriend or a trophy wife, which I think is unfair for many because they're really in love. But for a lot, you know, it's mainly physical. But I don't think there's anything wrong with that because age is just a number. You can be 40 and have the immaturity of a 16-year-old man. But you can be 25 and be mature, as let's say, in your thinking as a 40-year-old. So whatever floats your boat matches you. You have to match the woman intellectually, or if it's just raw emotions and love and not just passion, or it can start from passion and develop into love in a movie, or even in real life for certain people, I wouldn't mind doing a movie with that.
Like,
although it would be weird with Danielle, though, because, you know.
Yeah. But I like something
he's like
different.
My aborted nephew.
No, but I like...
ex-nephew to be.
No, but I like the provocation. I like the, you know, just the thought of you doing a love story with one of these millennial superstars. Parang, you know, it's exciting.
Yeah.
Is it, what's going to happen? How are they going to do it? What story?
Well, I have to look the part first. I have to be, you know, attractive enough for someone their age to fall in love with. I remember when I went to one of, Casey was in high school then, in IS, and I did a talk about careers. It was career day, so parents were invited to talk about what they were doing for work and talked about my job, and after they were going, that's your mom? Because I was really, and you know, your mom, they have a crush on you. Not everybody, of course, a few of them. So I would, it would be amazing to do something like that, you know.
You know,
because 50-year-olds now, they don't look like 50.
No, I want to tell you something, but I don't want to name names.
Yes.
There are young basketball players now in the collegiate circuit who would say, sabi ko, sinong crush mo? Sharon Cuneta.
Sino to?
I'll tell you later.
Joke.
I'll tell you later.
No, but sorry. It makes me...
No,
you know,
but that's what I'm trying to say.
Because
when you say, you know, I have to look good for them, hindi eh.
Kuya, it does something for a woman's self-confidence.
Of course.
That's all it is, yeah. It's not like I'm going to go after these guys. And go. It's just nice to know, oh, they still appreciate my efforts to look good.
But you would be surprised that a lot of these young guys, or maybe even girls, don't look for the... you know, the stereotype.
Totoo. Well, maybe.
That's why I was excited, you know, when somebody said, what could happen in a movie where Sharon, for example, and James Reid or, well, you're not comfortable with Danielle.
Not Danielle, but I would love to work with Danielle.
Diba?
Danielle on his own. Kathryn on her own, as well as Liza and Kenito.
And
what
she
calls Kenito.
Ken, right.
Ken. And who she calls Kenito, rather. And, or together, no?
Yeah.
Whoever wants to do a movie with me, whoever wants to give me, it will all depend on the story.